So good morning, Abhinesh bhai. So you have been recommended for your NDA in fourth attempt. So I would like to know your journey right from first attempt to this to your last attempt.
Okay, so if I talk about my journey, so my first attempt was of TES 43, and this attempt was in 2020 in Feb. Then in that attempt I was conference out. Then in my second attempt, that was of NDA 144, I was conference out again. That was in June 2020. Then I talk about my third attempt, that was NDA 145, that was in December 2020. So in that attempt, I got recommended, but due to some medical reason, I was declared unfit. Then again in NDA 146, that was my SSB was in April 2021. I got recommended, and this time I'm medically fit.
So you must be waiting for your merit list, right?
Right.
So when was your first written attempt of NDA?
My first attempt for written was in 2019. That was NDA 1 2019 in April.
That was 12th appearing or after 12th?
After 12th, just after 12th, means
Achha, okay,
my
that is
class 12th was.
okay. Yeah, got it.
Right.
So did you pass in that attempt? Did you qualify that attempt?
No, in my first attempt of written, I failed that. I
Okay,
was not
okay.
able to clear that.
Okay.
Right.
So there are lots of thoughts in an aspirant's mind ki since I have failed in this attempt and self-doubt and many other things go on. So how did you manage that thing and you continued your process for your next attempt?
First attempt can be said like an experience for the second attempt. You have cleared your class 12th, and just after class 12th, you cannot like suppose yourself to clear NDA because you have been from science stream and you have not been in touch for GAT. And again, if I talk about the maths, there are many tricky questions, some short tricks, some formula based, some many other types of questions that basically come into NDA only. So these type of questions and that particular mindset for clearing the NDA is very much required, and that one cannot have during the course of class 12. So after getting failed, I tried to gather all the strength that I gathered for first attempt, and I was clear in my mind that yes, I have to clear the written first. Because for going into the SSB, you need to clear the written. And the motivation for clearing the written is only to go for the SSB. So that's the motivation. And once you gather all the strength, then written can be cleared with the right mindset and right preparation strategy.
Now the NDA 2 2021 is held on 5th September, and today is 4th May. So exactly 4 months are remaining for those who will be appearing in that written exam. So what are your
Right.
tips for those who will be appearing on that in that exam?
So my tips or strategy that I can say will be like first, those who are from a science background, those who have taken maths in class 12, they have to focus on maths. If they can make their maths strong, and if they can score in maths, because maths is scoring, you can prepare for the concept and you can get good marks in maths. So once you get good marks, then you will also have confidence for studying for the GAT. So my strategy means my tips will be that you should focus on the maths, and after maths you can focus on English. And in maths particularly, focus first on the formula based question, because in NDA there are somewhere around 50% to 60% questions based on formula or small tricks. So you can focus on that, and after that some concept based questions and questions of probability. Means there are many questions of probability in NDA exam, and once you are clear with the concept of probability, you can do all the questions. So go for that. Some easy chapters like trigonometry can be done. So these questions will be score booster for you. And then if I talk about English, so try to do the grammar portion so that you can easily cover the error part. There are 10 questions of error. Practice some unseen passages so that you can do all the 10 questions of unseen passage. And you can read about the synonym antonym so that you can be able to do around 7 to 8 synonym as well as antonym. you can read some idiom and phrases so that you can do 2 to 3 idiom phrases in that. By that, you will be able to do around 35 questions of English. So if you are able to do good in maths, then like 30 to 35 questions in English, then normal basic science questions that can be done in GAT part that are more based on class 10th to 12th, some questions of class 12. So basic part of science can be done. And this way you can easily clear the written part. Means you should also focus on the history and you should focus on the polity part more, because polity is something that is very limited. So you can do the questions of polity, and history and geography is more vast. So you can go for the questions that are sure shot that comes every year in the geography. Like if I talk about, there must be 1 or 2 question of river, there must be 1 or 2 question of mountain. So you can clear those chapters first so that you can clear that question particular.
Would you like to recommend some books? There is a very popular book in market, Pathfinder. So is it really helpful or sirf market mein naam bana diya gaya uska?
For history or geography or the GAT part, I can say that it is a good book. Like the thing that is in Pathfinder is same as the Lucent GK. So you can go for any book like the Pathfinder or the Lucent. But for maths, you should not go for Pathfinder. You can go for Pathfinder for some basic concept, but for clearing it with good marks, you should not go for Pathfinder. You should go for R.S. Agrawal, or you can go for, means practice can be done from any book. There is a book of Arihant that is of 10 years paper. Means not previous year paper, they have created some practice papers. So you can go for that book. This will be better for practice. Means there are around 1200 questions in that book for maths only. So it will be good for practice. And along with that, previous year is very much required to do well.
So according to you, what is a safe score in written examination? Ki itna aap laoge to merit mein to pakka hi hai aapka.
If you are able to go for 420, around marks 420, then you can surely get into the merit. Because getting 400 is not safe, because people are scoring more. This time I have met many people who have scored more than 500. So for a safe score, you should be scoring somewhere around 420. That will be a safe score for merit.
So this is done for written part. Ki written mein you should prefer these books. After 12th, मतलब formula main है, ये सब हो गया written part
का. Right.
Yeah. Yes. Now comes to SSB. So did you start your SSB preparation right after knowing कि you will be clearing the exam, or did you wait for the result and then started for SSB? What did you do?
No, I started the preparation just after giving my exam, because there are many answer keys in market as you clear the as you go for the written. On the very next day, you will be able to get your marks checked. So if you are scoring somewhere around 400 or 380 plus, then you are clear in your mind that you can clear the written. So you should go for the preparation of SSB right from that, because it takes around 3 months to know the process first of SSB, because knowing the process is more important in SSB, and then creating that mindset, then again working for that. So you will be required a good time. So I started my preparation just after my written.
So did you go for any coaching, or did you buy the books for OIR and PPDT or something like that?
First, I bought a book for SSB for knowing the process, and it was detailed process given in that book. So I went through that process, and there were some questions related to OIR were also given. And on internet, there's a lot of content that can be given for OIR. So I practiced my OIR from internet and from that particular book. Then I went along the process from that book only.
So which book was that? Can you name it?
It was a Guide to SSB Interview by Dr. Gamanda and Kenneth Rajan.
So do you really think ki jo first SSB logo ka rehta hai aspirants ka, it is a golden chance for them?
Yes, if you are having a good preparation, if you are having a good mindset, then first chance will be a better option for clearing the SSB, because you are not aware about the process, and the people who are there to judge you or to assess you are somewhere knowing that you are very raw, you are not knowing the process. So there is not a great advantage, means you have to do the same thing in your first attempt as well as if it is your last attempt. But there is a difference of mindset of the assessors, that this boy is coming for the first time and this boy is coming for the second, third or fourth time. So there must be some difference in the judgment, that if a small mistake is done by the first, the people who are coming for the first attempt can be ignored, but it cannot be ignored for the people who are coming in fourth attempt or fifth attempt. So it is not a golden attempt, but yes, it can be said a better chance for clearing the SSB.
So according to you, is SSB coaching really required, or a normal guidance can also work for your SSB attempts?
A normal guidance can work, because it is only about the mindset. First, you should be aware about the process. Then you should be aware about what should be done in the process. And means what you should do during that process. And the third thing, that is your personality. Means according to every moment, you have to react somewhere different. And it totally based on your, means it depends on your personality, that how you react on that particular situation. So it is not a coaching required. Means a true guidance that is about the process, what you should do in the process, then your personality, that works.
So do you think English is really important for SSB? Like, is it a myth or a truth ki without English you can't pass the SSB round?
As per my knowledge, like what I have performed, yes, English is required. Means you should not be a very pro in English, but you can be an average. At least you should be able to communicate your thoughts somewhere in English. Means people were with me who were not that great in English, but they were trying to speak in English. It is not required that you should be speaking English fluently and permanently, but at least you should be giving some tries. You should be speaking somewhat English in that particular process. And then if you are having a good command on English, then you will be having better confidence. And in your DD, when you are speaking fluently in English, then the people around you will be having a better impact. So it is like advised by me that you should have a good command. But if you are not having that much, then you should practice, and it can be created like within some days.
And how important is general knowledge in SSB? Because mostly the GD topics, the lecturer topics are usually on international relations only. So what all should aspirant do on for SSB in terms of general knowledge?
So for general knowledge, yes, it is required for the SSB. If you are having a better general knowledge, then you will be having good command over your themes of TAT. If you are having better knowledge, then you can be creating better themes for your TAT, and you can have some better sentences in your WAT. And if you are aware about the things around you, then you can do it well in the SRT also. You are sitting in your interview and he can ask anything. So it is advised to go for you should go with a better preparation of GK. And then if I talk about the GD round, there GK is what is required. Because if you are having good knowledge, then only you can create a good impact on the GTU. Then only you can tell your perception, your views, that what you think about that particular topic or what is given in your lecturate as well. You have to have a good command over GK. Otherwise, lecturate cannot be only on your views. You have to give some data. Based on that, you can only give your views. So if you are having a good GK, then you will be also having better confidence. And you have cleared your NDA exam, then already you are having good command on GK. So you can have that surplus in your thing for SSB. If you are having that good GK.
You cleared your SSB in which round, in which attempt?
It was my third attempt that I cleared my SSB.
Third attempt you cleared your SSB, yeah. So in first two attempts you were conferenced out, right?
Right.
So what kept you motivated ki nahi yaar abhi to SSB nikalna hi hai, matlab fauj mein jana hi hai kaise bhi karke, wo motivation kya tha aapke dil mein?
It is only the SSB that is the motivation. Once you go to the SSB, you will be experiencing all those things there, their commands or whatever the process is there, the people around you and the environment that they create. I went to Allahabad SSB and it is like five boards are there, the things, the environment, the greenery, the cleanliness, the process, the discipline that they are maintaining, that people are coming and giving you commands, you have to go there, you have to go there, you are given a particular time, you have to go to mess on that particular time only. So the discipline, the environment that they created in my first attempt, I was impressed from that. Means, yes, I was having in my mind that I have to join army, but that environment gave me other boost.
Yeah, since you were conferenced out two times, and so what kept you motivating ki nahi yaar abhi to fauj mein hi jana hai, abhi to kaise bhi karke NDA mein hi jana hai?
It is only the environment of SSB that motivated me to go for the other attempts, because once I went in the first attempt, the things that were around me, the environment, the greenery, the discipline that everyone was giving command to go from here to there, and the discipline that you have to go on a particular time to the mess and you have to be well dressed, and that Sarvdharmasthal in Allahabad SSB. So these all were creating a good impact on my mind. And yes, I was clear in my mind that I have to go into the army. But once I went to the SSB, it was my first exposure to the things of army, because I have been from civilian background. I don't have any touch to army backgrounds. And then going to the SSB and having that experience, it added to the motivation. And once I went for my first attempt, then in my second attempt, I saw the same things. And the other thing, that once you fail in something, then there is a distress in your mind that you have to do that thing. Until you are not achieving that particular success in that thing, then your mind is not giving you rest. So that dedication that I have to do this thing that that I have failed in. So that was in my mind that I have to clear that, because I failed two times. So something must be there that I can improve.
So there is a lot of, you know, peer pressure, family pressure when you don't succeed in something which you really want. And like somewhat it is true to ourselves ki haan matlab thoda bahut to ghar walon ko bhi lagta hi hai ki matlab nahi niklega to kya karega, aisa bahut common hai bahut. So how did you overcome that, like what did you tell to your parents, and what all did you do to ki ab to bas ho gaya nikalna hi hai?
So first thing that I will advise, means I was not having any plan B, but everyone should have a plan B. Because you are not clear in your mind that you have to clear your SSB. Means SSB is not something that you know yourself that you will clear it. So it is like advice to have something option if you are not able to go to the NDA. Because there are many reasons that you clear everything and you go into medical and you find that you are not medically fit. So these are the things that you should have a better option if you are not able to clear the NDA part. But if you are having a plan B, then the pressure on your mind will be decreased. And same will be with your parents, that they will be clear that if you are not having, if you are not able to clear the NDA, then you will do this. So this will not create a bad, means a bad pressure on your mind. And along with that, like, as you said, the pressure. So family understands the pressure. If you are doing the part of your hard work, and if they are seeing it, so they are clear that yes, you are keep on doing your hard work and you will clear something, you will get the success. But the pressure around you, the society or your friends, that they are keep interviewing you that you are going for the SSB again and again and you are not able to clear it. This pressure can be solved by the things that they are saying, that you should gather their words, and you should be experiencing that. Yes, I have cleared my SSB and now what is their reaction? So you should be gathering that strength from that. And yes, these are the things that that is very important. If you are not having pressure, then you will be not be working for the particular thing. So pressure is required. And once you are having the pressure, the strategy, the way, and your hard work get doubles. So that is required.
Since you are from a civilian background, then how did it spark in your mind ki I want to become an armed forces officer? Because many civilians ka it's not like ki army mein jana hai, navy mein jana hai, bahut sare civilians nahi sochte. there are only a few people who really want to go in Army, Navy, Air Force from a civilian background. So what made you think I want to be in Armed Forces?
Right. So as it starts with everyone, every civilian like watches movies or watches army officers from somewhere, from television or something. So it all started like that. And once I saw that, then I explored more about that life. And there was a retired, sorry for retired. He was Shaheed in Kargil War. There was one of the Major Avinash Singh Bhadauria. He was awarded by Kirti Chakra. And his life was based on army only. And even his wife, after his martyrdom, she joined the army. So he used to live around 5 to 10 kilometers from my house. So in Kanpur, it is very famous about his stories. And there are many things related to means, many parks or statues of him. That so I saw that those statues, and I saw that there is a dignity in that statue only. And the life that he is living, the people, the respect that people are giving to army officers is something that cannot be matched in any other profession. And you are living for the respect only, means the respect that people can give you. So because of all those things, the respect and the life that army gives, something like you are having a new task every day. And once you are doing a new task every day, then you are adding to your confidence. So these are the things that motivated me to join army.
So when you finally cleared your SSB, your medicals, well, written SSB medicals, then what all things went through your mind? Ki ab to ho gaya SSB, ab medicals ho gaya, bas now remains the merit list. So what all things were going in your mind?
So it is like first when I got medically out, then there were many things that were in my mind. Like I was not able to enjoy myself. So once after like my medicals were means I was declared medically unfit, then I was not able to enjoy myself. And after the medical means when I got declared that I am medically unfit and my another SSB for NDA 146, there was a gap of 10 to 15 days. And it was days full of chaos. It means will I be able to make it again? Will I be able to clear the SSB again? Means there were so many myths around, like even after getting recommended, I was having myths that people who are recommended will surely get recommended in another attempt. But it is not something like that. You have to perform well in another attempt also. So once after those 15 days and those 5 days of SSB again, people around you are saying that you are recommended, you will again get recommended. And then the problems that will I get medically fit this time or not. So once everything happened and once I was declared that yes, I'm medically fit, then only there was a rest in my mind that yes, I have made it. And then my story, all the story means my those efforts for medical in my previous attempt and those conference outs and those two times recommendation, those journey, those experiences, those friends that I made, those some who motivated me, some who were with me in my failures also. So these all were coming, my expectation of my parents, what life I'm going to give them now. These were the things that I was having. And again, the preparation for joining the academy, what I should do for a better training, life of training in that NDA. So these were the things that I was thinking.
So, according to you, what all physical activity should an aspirant do to, you know, perform well in GTO task or like ground task in SSB?
So, means one should have a good physical personality, because if you are having a good physical personality, it will also create a better impact on your group. The people that are in your group will say that yes, you have a good physique, you can help me in the group obstacle race. And you are going into the interview, those who are means the interviewing officer that will see you will think that you are doing something, because if you are saying that you want to join army, then you are dedicated enough. to work on your physical ability. And army is the life full of physical activities. So if you are doing it from now onwards, then you will be able to cope up with that. And into the JITO task, it will be better for having a better physical personality. So normal exercises like running is most important because of having a good stamina. And the things like push-ups and pull-ups and squats and core exercises, these are enough for a person like around age of us. And if you are having that these things, if you are doing, then it will also boost your confidence that, yes, I can do 10 push-ups or I can do 20 push-ups. Now I can do 40 push-ups. So this will add your confidence that you can tell in your interview also. So it is advised to have that better personality of physical aspect.
Do you think gym is a necessity for an aspirant, or normal home workout can also do it?
Home workout is enough, but means it is all about your interest. If you are having interest in gym, then you can go. It will also add your confidence. There's no limit of having experiences in life.
So, what were your experiences in these four SSB? Like, what is that one thing that SSB taught you?
It is the patience that SSB has taught me from my first attempt when I got confidence out. From my first attempt of my written when I failed in written, and then clearing the written, then again getting confidence out in the SSB, again getting confidence out in the SSB, then getting recommended and getting medically unfit, waiting for long hours in medical time. Means if you are going in military hospital, people, the OPD is there. And once the OPD is done, then only you can go for the medicals from the doctors. So that waiting for long hours, that has taught me patience. And it is very much required for the SSB. Means in those 15 qualities, patience is not mentioned, but it is checked in your preparation time.
So according to you, what is the most important aspect for a candidate to, you know, appear in SSB? Like, is it the mindset? Is it the discipline? Or what is it according to you? Like, anything which is very important, which can make a candidate surely a recommended candidate?
So for me, everything is required. Means mindset and the preparation that you are doing. But still, the mindset is more required. Means what was my strategy? That I worked hard for the SSB. And before the day, like if I'm going for the GTO day one. So before that, I was talking to myself. I was making that mindset that how I am going to perform tomorrow. What all the things that I can face, that I can face the crowd like that. I can face the group who are making cheers in that particular group. So how I'm going to handle that? How I'm going to handle that obstacle? How I'm going to handle that group? If a group is doing that, then how I can handle? So the mindset that you can make before a day in the SSB, you should prepare for that particular day. From your journey, but you should also make that mindset a day before the that particular, the D-Day. You should make a mindset before that day. So this will help when you are standing on the ground. Then you will be remembering that I thought this in the previous night, so I can perform like this. So this will help more. So mindset, that I can say. But still, the combination of everything, mindset, hard work, the preparation that you are doing, the support, and everything that you are doing in the society, if you are contributing somewhere, that all thing matters.
So, since you are a recommended candidate, so do you think that those 15 OLQs which are present in everywhere in internet, all the OLQs will be there in a recommended candidate? Is it like that, or we need to slowly and means in start, we need to slowly build it, or what was your thinking on this?
So I was never worried about the OLQs. I was worried about my preparation, that how I can perform well. And it is something like you can only show your personality. You cannot fake it that, yes, I am having that quality. If you are having those quality, then it will be shown. And yes, if you are preparing well, then these qualities will be like nourished. And these qualities will be, if I can say, then if you are rubbing again and again, then these qualities will come out better. So if you are doing a better preparation, if you are like doing physical activities daily, if you are reading something, and if you are doing these preparation that is required, you are practicing the stories or practicing the words, sentences, then this will show you the way that how you can show those qualities there. And that is, you are means being worried about the OLQs is not required. Being worried about the preparation is required. If you are preparing well, and if you are able to show that your preparation there, if you are able to perform your preparation, then you will be able to make it.
And one last question regarding SSB. So did you regularly read the newspaper?
No, I have never read a single newspaper in my particular journey.
So what did you do for your current affairs in for SSB?
It was social media and the YouTube, because on YouTube, if you are reading things on YouTube, then it will be giving you better horizon. And if you are reading it only in a newspaper, then you are only reading it. But if you are listening it on YouTube, it is going to be mentioned on your mind, and you are having better horizon on that particular duration of video. You can think about your aspect also. So this is something means. In that current affairs thing, YouTube was better than newspaper. But yes, newspaper should be read. Means I have not read, but it can be read. And it is a good option because you are having some better knowledge in newspaper. And reading it will also can be said as your hobby. So these things will add to your exposure.
So what will be your final message to all the aspirants like me who are preparing for NDA written and SSB round?
So I would say that keep on having the patience. And if you are doing your part, then one day you will be able to make it. But do your part with full dedication and keep on doing that. And if you are doing it with full dedication, have some patience. And as there is a very motivating line that left hand the day will come. So